Review. Review.
Why did we watch Bloodshot?
Because we spoke about it loads.
You spoke about it loads.
You spoke about it too. You were telling me anytime we mentioned Bloodshot, you were silent.
Yeah, I wasn't here. It was Chrisbot 3000.
All right, well, Chrisbot 3000 wanted to watch Bloodshot. Chrisbot 3000, what's it about?
He's not here. Boop, beep, boop. Bloodshot is a
you
film.
You fucking liar.
Blood Touch is a film from 2020.
Bloodshot.
Starring everyone's favourite pack of ham on legs, Vincent Diesel.
He's a pack of ham.
As a
pack of ham.
Soldier turned super soldier who was hell-bent on getting revenge for his murdered wife.
As a pack of ham.
Uh-huh. Will he get revenge?
What are you asking me?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Will he be at all legible?
You might not be.
Will he emote even the simplest emotion?
Yeah, family.
Brilliant.
What did you like about Bloodshot?
On the whole, it doesn't shit the bed, does it?
No. You go into it thinking, this is going to be the worst film all year.
Yeah.
And it's surprisingly not bad.
It's not good.
No, it's not bad.
See you next week.
So we were watching it. There's like time loops, isn't there? So you get through like the first initial time loop and then a twist happens and then you're like, whoa. Yeah. But that's like the first 40 minutes of the film.
Yeah, yeah.
And I genuinely thought, oh, that's so what we're 15 minutes in?
Yeah.
And it's 45 minutes in or something. Like, good job, Bloodshot. Wasn't expecting that from you. It is completely throwaway action film.
Yeah.
But good job on Bloodshot. Good job, Vin Diesel.
Well done, Blood Touch. No, not good job, Vin Diesel.
Good job, Vin Diesel.
No.
There's not a lot you can actually talk about with this film, apart from it just being surprisingly not shit. It just is what you expect it to be, throwaway action film.
It's as if an algorithm watched every action film from the last 20 years and then wrote their own.
But they say in it, what is this? All the cliches from movies?
The first sequence, it's essentially a Michael Bay greatest hits sequence. But they explain that away in the twist. Should we say what the twist is?
Go on.
In that he's a super soldier who keeps getting his memories altered. So that sequence that we see was created by one of the characters.
That's the twist?
Yeah, he's Memento.
Oh, I thought the twist was he could act.
Not from this film.
He carries on his streak of not being able to do much.
It's like he was paralyzed in the face.
On like the front half, the top half. No, that's how it normally works. It's got a bit of charm to it, hasn't it?
Not really.
I thought it had a little bit of charm, considering I was expecting like a pile of crap. Got a little bit of, like, before. It's not bad charm.
Yeah, you were saying that it doesn't feel cynical, does it?
No.
It feels like someone has tried to make a film.
But it genuinely feels like someone has put effort into this story.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I like the workout scene when he's like, oh, how strong am I? Oh, what, a cup? Yeah, cup, I'm strong.
Yeah.
Well, what's this? A weight. Oh, yeah, a weight. What's this? A car. Oh, yeah, a car. Do you think like Vin Diesel was trying to be funny, or do you think he was trying to be serious?
I think he was trying to be serious.
But it just, for some reason, comes off funny.
Yeah, he's trying to do surprised.
And it comes off like an airplane bit. Like, huh? Did you notice that every time he punched someone, he had massive Pierre Hench punches? Yeah. That was amazing.
The strongest man in the world.
Kaboom! Good boss, big punches. He punched the bag that's covered in tape. Oh, you know that bag that's just got a layer of tape over it?
Yeah.
I managed to break that layer of tape. I'm pretty strong.
He punches all the way through the punch bag, so he decides, oh, I best punch this load-bearing column.
The load-bearing column? Yeah. He's like, oh, whoa, I can punch concrete and it doesn't hurt my hand. I'm going to destroy this because there's only one load-bearing concrete column in this room. Yeah. Oh, please stop doing that.
It's a billion-dollar facility.
Yeah, you're going to crush all our leftover punch bags.
It's just a rehash of every other action film. You can maybe excuse the first sequence. It's a first-time director who's doing a Michael Bay impression, and you can sort of put a little line in there, you know, that excuses that.
Yeah.
But the rest of the film just is completely unoriginal. Even the twists, not original. But I've never seen that much flour in a film before, have you?
There was a lot of flour. It looked cool in slow motion, and then you pointed out it's flour.
Yeah, it's a really boring, mundane thing.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
But it's all cool and dusty in slow motion. It's flour. Yeah. That I think that sums up the film a lot. You're watching it and you're kind of like, oh yeah, that's okay, and then you realize, oh no, wait, it's just flour. It's a bit boring. There's nothing special to it. They've just dressed it up pretty well. I was really scared at the opening scene. Not scared, but annoyed, because like his wife dies immediately. It's like, oh no, just we've got a woman character. Oh, she's in she's dead. So now Vin Diesel has to take revenge.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a bit annoying.
Yeah.
Just kill, what, no. But then, and then the twist happens and she didn't actually die. But you still killed a woman within the first few minutes of your film.
Oh, yeah.
What are you playing at? Kill Vin Diesel. Oh, you did? I had a big problem with dialogue in this film. Didn't know what people were going on about. You were just like, and then we shoot them and like, what? What are they saying? Couldn't make out what they were saying. They were ineligible. And Vin Diesel can't talk.
Or act.
Over and over and over again.
Yeah, he's really bad, isn't he?
Yeah, but no, it's Vin Diesel. You've not seen Fast and Furious?
No.
Oh.
You think he's trying his best?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, everyone else in this film feels like they're in a B-movie. Whereas Vin Diesel doesn't. Vin Diesel, I think, takes every movie seriously, but he's just not a good... He can't act. I think that's why he's liked. I think that's why people like him. It's because you can tell he cares about the films that he's in.
Can't imagine he cares that much.
Why?
Because he could speak clearly.
No, but that's the thing. I think he's trying to express to you that he really cares, but he can't express emotion. Everyone else, fine to shit. I'm not going to remember any performances.
Not even the...
Wiggins!
Yeah, the congealed parody.
Okay, yeah. So, we were talking about this.
Yeah.
And as soon as Wiggins came on...
Yeah.
He's just irritating. You want to kill it. And then you made the comparison of Don Cheadle in Ocean's films.
Uh-huh.
And then he kind of got bearable. He's not as horrific or an eyesore as Don Cheadle.
You bloody nosed it right up.
He's in England because they probably have to film in England. But he didn't go on about Cockney things all the time. He just did his accent, didn't he?
Oh, was he trying to be a Cockney?
Like, he was eating noodles instead of eating, a roast dinner. Yeah, fish and chips, pickled egg and a pint. So I didn't mind it that much because they didn't go mental with it. Who's your best one?
My best one?
Yeah.
Is Guy Pearce.
Hard to argue. He could have got more, though.
What other than shouting at a big screen? Like Bourne.
It's Jason. Wait, what? Jason Bourne screams at a room.
I hate you, bedroom. I hate you, kitchen.
Who am I? Library. You ever play Cluedo with Jason Bourne?
No.
Didn't stop screaming.
When is this?
What?
Yeah, Guy Pearce, he's always good. When he turned up, I was like, oh, it's Guy Pearce.
Nice. Good job on casting.
Yeah. And he was good. And like immediately go, oh, he's going to be the baddie. But I'm going to enjoy a little bit of this film.
How is he going to be the baddie?
Yeah.
Go on then.
What's your best one?
The opening 40 minutes. I was pleasantly surprised at how well it was handled. Like it went downhill rather than...
Uphill.
Yeah, it started well. Who's your worst one?
My worst one was all the lens flares.
Oh.
So many lens flares.
Really?
Yeah.
I think I spotted one.
Loads of them.
Well, they're going to put it in because of J.J. Abrams, isn't it? Oh, do you know what's going to be cool? Don't say lens flare. Lens flare.
You know what I think this scene needs?
Don't say lens flare.
Lens flare.
Good idea, director.
What's your worst one?
My worst one is Tibbs. He was always like spitting and putting food everywhere. And he has spider arms. He's a knobhead. Hate him. Would you recommend Bloodshot?
No. It's just super generic. There's nothing new or interesting or original to it.
Mm.
It's fine. If you want like a throwaway, forgettable action film, there's a lot worse films out there. But nah. Would you recommend it?
No.
Why?
It's completely fine.
Yeah.
Wouldn't say it's good.
Yeah.
But it's not complete dog shit.
Oh, no. No. By no means.
You don't need to watch this. Don't watch Bloodshot. What is your score, please?
I'll give it a 4.
Oh,
I was thinking, is it a five? But it's not fine.
Oh.
Most of it is fine, but Vin Diesel's not fine.
That's because you don't know him, Chris.
It was distracting how many things from other films there are in it. What would you score it?
I'd give it a five. Totally fine. Didn't dislike it, but didn't like it. Vin Diesel's Vin Diesel. Yeah, five.
Score, bros.
Family. Do you think you could eat Vin Diesel's face?